some more specials we are going to discuss before we move forward and start with AngularJS. These specials will definitely help in understanding how AngularJS is created. What's the feature they thought of supporting while creating it? This is about MVC, and it's a design pattern. MVC stands for Model, View, and Controller. MVC is widely used on client as well as server-side coding. Now the next question will come into your mind, what is a design pattern? Design pattern is a solution to the common problem. We got many similar problems in our life, right? Say we need a place to keep our cash. So different people used to keep their cash at different places. So we devised a common solution for the problem. What we call it? A bank, right? Similarly, across many IT projects, we are facing the same problem again and again. To solve these same problems, someone developed a solution called MVC design pattern, a common solution to software development projects. We already had a discussion on the similar problem we discussed in the last lesson. So we know this code is coupled with the UI and it's not testable and it's not clean. And we can use MVC to solve this problem. MVC is basically separation of concerns. So we have to separate our concerns related to user interface, data, and business logic into different components. MVC basically helps us in structuring our code. MVC is made up of three different components, as we know, model, view, and controller. The first component, model, is responsible for storing data and even perform action on that data. The second component, view, is the presentation of the data. And the third component, controller, is responsible for the action taken by the user on the view component, and those actions are handled in a controller. So we may call it as a business logic. Why am I saying this? Because there are different ways to encapsulate business logic in AngularJS. And all of these three components work together to make a complete application. Now let's try to understand MVC with an example. Suppose we got a requirement for creating the MP3 player, which will display a list of songs and some controls for play, pause, and to play next and previous song. Got it? I think the requirement is quite simple. Now let's try to separate the concern into three different components of MVC. So what do you think? What will be the first component, that is model, for our presentation? Any guess? Right, an array of songs. We can call it a playlist. Next, how we are going to represent this data as a view. That's the second component of MVC. Maybe something like this, list of songs and buttons to control the player. There it is. We have a nice MP3 player with the data or a model and its presentation, or we can call it a view. But it's of no use if the user will not be able to play the song, right? So when the user clicks on a play button, the song should be played. And this activity of playing song should not be handled by the view. It doesn't seem to be its responsibility, right? So we can delegate this responsibility to the third component, and that's controller. So we can create a controller, say music controller, which will handle the responsibility of playing the songs. We can create a function named play to handle this responsibility. Seems nice, right? So we have the MP3 player playing songs, but when we click on any of the song to play, we may require to display some more information related to that song, maybe an artist's name and its genre. The controller can handle this responsibility for us. Like after executing the play function, the controller can load the data related to the current song, maybe from the server, and this new data will be stored into the model. We can call it current song info. As we got new data, we should have a presentation for it. So we may present the song info something like this. I think you got an idea how these three different components work together in an application. Dividing your application into these three components also keeps the application objects loosely coupled from each other. Now let's spend some time on our bad version of addition of two numbers. So can you guess what's the data here? Obviously, these two numbers entered into the text input elements, and the presentation is our HTML. We don't have any specific controller here, but this calculate function is a business logic. So we need some way to take these data values from these text inputs and we don't want to have this DOM access code inside my business logic, right? So can I call my business logic something like this? A function with arguments to work on, and AngularJS helps us in solving these problems. I don't want to throw any AngularJS code here right now, as we are going to solve this problem in coming lectures.